On January 8, 1811, between 200 and 500 slaves revolted in the largest slave uprising on U.S. soil in Louisiana. These slaves wanted freedom, and they believed they had to fight for it. This slave revolt is referring to the German Coast Uprising of 1811. It is the largest slave resistance in United States history, yet it is left out of our textbooks and is rarely talked about. This is known as historical amnesia, where history is forgotten. Although the German Coast Uprising of 1811 is rarely talked about in history, it is an important uprising since it showed how slaves pushed to try to gain their freedom and independence, while white planters tried to suppress their influence from spreading in order to keep the slavery system intact. The German Coast Uprising took place in the Orleans Territory. The Orleans Territory was part of the land received from the Louisiana Purchase. It was acquired from Napoleon, who at the time was the ruler of France. However, in the 1800s, the Haitian Revolution was going on, so he had to give up the North American land to the U.S. to focus on a rebellion, while also having to fight the British in the Napoleonic Wars for European superiority. The principal organizer and leader of the German Coast Uprising was one man named Charles Deslondes. He revolted as he was inspired by the events in Haiti, where the enslaved population took over that island nation and abolished slavery. The Deslondes family had been one of the many slave-holding families in Saint Domingo, which is present-day Haiti, that fled the Haitian Revolution, which took place between 1791 and 1804, where slaves rose up and revolted against French rule, ultimately being successful in the end. The victory of Africans in gaining their freedom in Haiti had a powerful and stimulating effect on Africans held in bondage all over the world, especially in the Western Hemisphere. The Deslondes family fled to Louisiana for refuge. The Deslondes family acquired land and restarted their slave-holding sugarcane operations in St. John the Baptist Parish. Charles, in Louisiana, was a free black man living in the Orleans Territory. Charles was employed by a nearby plantation owner, Manuel Andrew, as a wagon driver. He recruited slaves from Andrew's plantation and along the German coast. He organized secret meetings and appointed officers, Cook and Quammen, who were also from Haiti. With inspiration from the Haitian Revolution, Charles' first goal was to take over the Andrew plantation. On January 8, 1811, on Andrew's plantation, La Place, located in St. Charles Parish, Louisiana, the slaves threw down their work and axes and rebelled together to show a sign of unity and fight for their freedom. They knew that if they failed, the consequences were most likely to be death, specifically from Gabriel's conspiracy in 1800, but they still fought because it's better than forced labor to them. Andrew's plantation was a good starting place as it was a warehouse for a local militia. The goal of Charles and the slaves was to capture the city of New Orleans and establish a black republic in Louisiana. Briefly after midnight on the 8th, the slaves took over Andrew's plantation. Today, there is only one historical marker where this event occurred. It is shown here with this cool-looking dude with the shades.
Although this is a fake scene and is not actually what happened on January 8th, 1811, I think it resembles it very well. I like to picture the man dressed up in blue as Charles Deslondes. The reason for that is because he's a free man and dresses more nicer than the slaves. Charles wants to start a revolt, and in order to do that, he starts it off by killing Andrew's son. Andrew then gets mad, tries to pull out his gun, but Charles gets to him and whips him. The man being whipped, resembling Andrew, doesn't die, and that is because he escaped. Again, this scene is fake and is not what actually happened. In more depth and elaborated on, here's what happened.
The slaves rose up and attacked the big house and assaulted Andrew and severely wounded him, but he was able to escape. Reported in the Sentinel Gettysburg newspaper, Andrew said, "An attempt was made to assassinate me by the stroke of an axe, and my poor son has been ferociously murdered by a horde of brigands." Andrew calling them a horde of brigands is significant as he views them as savages, a part of a gang, and shows no respect for him to prove that his race is superior to theirs. He also said his son was ferociously murdered, which is one of the whites who died. On that day, though, the slaves did make a fatal mistake by letting Andrew escape. He will be later indulged in the film.
After the attack on Andrew's plantation, the slaves began to move southward down the Mississippi River. They were gathering slaves and ammunition by raiding stores as they headed on their journey to New Orleans. Panicked whites reported that they were traveling in military style while heading there. They were beating drums, waving flags, and had uniforms that they stole from stores. On their way to New Orleans, along St. Charles Parish, they attacked a family manor owned by Jean Francis Trepanger. He tried to defend it, but the slaves killed him. He was another white today. As soon as Charles Perrette, a top militia officer for St. John and St. Charles Parishes, heard about the revolt, he notified Governor Claiborne of the attack. When word of the revolt got around, white fear was sparked and they instantly gathered the band of soldiers to put the rebellion down. Around 80 troops, led by no one other than himself, Manuel Andrew, went to put it down. On January 10th, 1811, the slaves' dreams of freedom were crushed. Just 20-ish miles off of New Orleans, they were absolutely met by whites. The defensive line of Andrew's troops met the slaves at Jack's Plantation near present-day Rivertown, located in Kenner. The slaves lost their hope and retreated. They retreated all the way back to Norco. During their retreat, a lot of them were either killed, captured, or escaped. Reports of around 40 to 60 slaves were killed. The revolt was put down. In the end, 66 slaves were killed in battle, 16 were executed, and 17 escaped or were dead. All the slaves weren't documented, so who knows what happened to the rest of the slaves. Those slaves who were captured and tried were most likely put to death. The reason for this is because the tribunal was completely biased. According to the civil record of St. Charles Parish and St. John the Baptist Parishes by Glenn R. Conrad, book number 41, entry number 2, in January 1811, tell us that the ones who were given the slaves' verdict was the plantation owners themselves. They were obviously going to put them to death because they were racist and completely biased. These trials lasted for 3 days on Destrehan Plantation. This shows how unjustly slaves were treated as the slaveholders were biased. Whites feared another revolt like this could happen again, so the ones who were dead, they cut off their heads and placed the slaves' heads on poles around the river to intimidate the slaves to never rebel again. Was the German Coast Uprising of 1811 a success? Well, in terms of them taking over New Orleans and establishing a Black Republic in Louisiana, that was not successful at all. However, it did spark white fear and showed what slaves were capable of, how smart slaves actually were in organizing a well-sophisticated revolt, how large the numbers could be, and the motives they have just to gain freedom. These slaves showed a strong message which they were willing to die for, but whites were allowed to suppress the message as the revolt took place a year too early before Louisiana became a state. So because it was a territory, information could be hidden a lot easier. On the 200th anniversary of the German Coast Uprising, Daniel Rasmussen released his book called American Uprising, The Untold Story of America's Largest Slave Revolt. He wrote this book for his senior thesis and studied for 2 years about the revolt and informed many people of what happened. If this revolt is ever talked about more, it will be because of this man. The German Coast Uprising of 1811 deserves to be talked about more. The historical amnesia was caused by the elites and racists back in the 1800s as they suppressed the revolt and did not want to talk about it, and they were able to do that as it was only a territory and not a state at the time. Today, we have a lot more information about this revolt, and we can talk about it more in history. This revolt tells the story of how slaves were almost successful in taking over New Orleans. This also shows how far slaves would go, how far they would push their limits, and how hard they would fight just to achieve equality and freedom, which they should have had for many, many years.